expensive home on the planet. In the inner city of Mumbai, India, not far from the poverty-stricken slums, on the renowned Altamont Road, stands Antilia, the most expensive home ever created. This home ascends 27 stories, stretching 568 feet high, granting the massive structure with prime views of the Arabian Sea. In technical terms, the home is the second most expensive residential property in the world, considering Buckingham Palace is worth around $5 billion. However, Buckingham Palace is considered a crown property, whereas Antilia is a private residence. And the most expensive private residential property at that, with some pricing estimates as high as $2 billion. Even still, any list in which a residence is preceded by Buckingham Palace pretty much guarantees that place is going to be over the top luxurious and is likely a house I'd love to move into. In this video, I'll take you on a virtual informative tour of this ostentatious estate, while engaging all of two of your senses. In this massive home, there are several ceilings that are double or triple heighted, so the 27-floored skyscraper looks more like a 50 or 60-floor building. Can you imagine only being as tall as an ordinary 27-floor building? Laughable. On some of the lower floors, there is a multi-level car lot that can hold 168 vehicles, including Mukesh's precious RS5 4 Maybach, a car for very important people. Somewhere in that car lot is also a car service station. But if cars aren't your style, don't worry. The home also has three helipads placed on the roof. Few things say billionaire like more than one helipad on the roof. Both the private car lot and helipads are violations of residential bylaws in Mumbai, but from what we can tell, no one has forced the billionaire's hand to make any changes. Above the car lot, you'll find an extravagant lobby composed of 9 elevators. Further up is a 2-story recreation center with a lap pool, a gym, a juice bar, a dance studio, and a yoga studio. Floors like these are how Jeff Bezos transformed his I Sell Books body to his I Sell What I Want physique. As you continue to ascend, you will eventually run into a spa and a ballroom. The ballroom is adorned with multiple crystal chandeliers that cover 80% of the ceiling, leaving a shameful 20% exposed and unadorned. To capitalize on the entertainment focus areas of the home, there's a movie theater that sits 50 viewers. There are multiple balconies and terraces with luscious gardens hanging over the sleek facade along the home. The vegetation attached to the sides of the building are meant to absorb sunlight in order to keep the interior as cool as possible. Hopefully that touch can put a dent in what must be a monstrous electricity bill. As if all this luxury wasn't enough of an escape from the hot, busy streets of Mumbai, the home comes fitted with an ice room equipped with a snow generator, meant to mimic a winter wonderland, a creative addition rivaled only by the likes of Winnie Wonka. The immaculate structure was designed by architects Perkins and Will out of Chicago, and the interior design was overseen by an Australian company called Brighton Holdings. While the 400,000 square foot building is home to just 6, it's also meant to make room for a staff of 600 cooks, cleaners, and security personnel. So that makes the size of the mansion less excessive, right? I double-checked that stat, by the way, and I can confirm 100 staff per family member. The building is named after a legendary island, also called the Isle of the Seven Cities. The tale of this island originates from an old Liberian legend in which bishops fleeing from the Muslim conquest of Hispania escaped to an island and created 7 settlements there. There's not much else on that fun fact, and no one seems to know why the owners of the home took to that fabled island, but that's the thing with being a billionaire. No one questions your decisions. Considering the unique shape of the skyscraper, and the fact that its construction cost not 6, not 7, not 8, but 10 figures, it'd be a fair assumption to presume the design of the home is symbolic, or at least, you know, on purpose. And that assumption would be correct. This incredible structure was meticulously crafted with Hindi influence and generously laced with religious symbolism. Within the 27 stories, there are 6 sections of the home that are meant to reflect earth, water, fire, air, sound, and light. These elements were placed from bottom to top, as the mimics, not Nickelodeon's Avatar, The Last Airbender, but the ascension to enlightenment. Throughout the mansion, there are two reoccurring motifs, the sun and the lotus. These symbols are meant to represent rebirth. The materials used to stem from these themes include marble, crystal, and none other than Mother of Pearl. There is a temple in the home in which the family of six goes to pray regularly. There are many statues of Hindu deities throughout the home, including the Hindu god Ganesh, revered as the remover of obstacles, and Shiva, the Hindu deity who destroys to make way for new creation. Along with religious themes and the motifs of lotus and sun, the house is said to have been inspired by the Atlantic Ocean. The owner of the $2 billion home is Mukesh Ambani, a petroleum titan, chairman of Reliance Industries, and, surprise, surprise, the richest man in India. Mukesh is responsible for a fifth of India's exports, which is absolutely outrageous considering India makes up for a third of the Earth's population. Mukesh's father created a business that turned into the world's biggest producer of polyester fibers and yarns. Mukesh multiplied his inheritance many times over to become one of the richest men in all of Asia. For years, Mukesh was a member of the top 10 richest people in the world. And during one surge in India's stock market in 2007, he was believed to be the richest man on the planet. But as of recently, he sits comfortably at the 20th spot. Mukesh is worth $40.1 billion and is 61 years old. Did someone ask for a list of the richest people on the planet? Okay, here it is. Number 1, Jeff Bezos, Amazon. Number 2, Bill Gates, Microsoft. Number 3, Warren Buffett, Berkshire Hathaway. Number 4, Bernard Arnault, Louis Vuitton. Number 5, Amancio Ortega, Zara. Number 6, follows Slim Pillou and family. Number 7, Mark Zuckerberg, Facebook. Number 8, Larry Ellison, Oracle. Number 9, Larry Page, Alphabet, co-founder of Google. Number 10, Charles Koch, Koch Industries. Number 11, David Koch, you guessed it, Koch Industries. Number 12, Sergey Brin, Google. Number 13, Michael Bloomberg, Bloomberg. Number 14, Mark Huate, Tencent Holdings. Number 15, Jim Walton, Walmart. Number 16, Rob Walton, Walmart. Number 17, Alice Walton, Walmart. Number 18, Steve Ballmer, Microsoft. Number 19, Francois Betancourt Myers and family, L'Oreal. Number 20, and our guy, Mukesh Ambani. We just love lists here at Mr. Luxury. As you might have noticed from the list, Mukesh is one of only two individuals from Asia to earn a spot on the list. Mumbai is the commercial capital of India and is also called the city that never sleeps because I guess they didn't know that slogan was already taken. This city is also home to the entertainment industry in India, so it's commonly known as Bollywood, yet another thing they ripped from the United States. While the city is home to the world's most expensive house, it's unfortunately also home to the world's largest slum. The popular film Slumdog Millionaire was set in Mumbai. The public reception of the house's creation has been harsh at best. I believe offending neighbors comes standard when you're creating a home worth over $1 billion, but there is certainly warrant for any offense taken in this particular case, I must admit. While the house was built on the richest stripe of land in the city, it's hard to not notice the contrast in a city like Mumbai, with such depths of poverty just blocks away. Gyan Prakash told the New York Times in 2010 that the home is in a way reflective of how the rich are turning their faces away from the city. In Mumbai, 40% of children under the age of 5 are underweight. The gap between the rich and the poor is as stark and vast here as any other place in the world. Still, there are some that bring up the charitable acts of the Ambani family, which include the creation of a hospital, when discussing the moral responsibilities of the family, not to mention numbers of the philanthropic ventures, specifically by Meeta Ambani, Mukesh's wife. Which is great and all, but no one is going to ignore the gargantuan gargantuan mansion towering over the city, or any of Mukesh's indulgences other than the mansion. Years before the creation of Antilia, Mukesh bought his wife an Airbus for her birthday for $16 million. He had the passenger jumbo jet refitted with a living room, a bedroom, satellite TV, a sky bar, and a spa. Unlike most families worth billions, the Ambani family owns just the one home as opposed to the expected several around the globe. Initially, the family shared a house with Mukesh's mother and brothers. But after Mukesh's father passed away of a stroke, he decided to break the bank on the 400,000 square foot home. The children of Mukesh and Nita all studied at universities in the States. Isha, the eldest daughter, recently graduated from Yale. Her twin brother, Akash, and younger brother, Anant, both graduated from Brown University. Not that I'm in any position to judge Mukesh as a father, but it's nice to see he raised three Ivy Leaguers. That's pretty much all I've got on Antilia and the Ambani family. As always,